The movie starts with Jennifer Slope heading to a shop to get the keys to a lot she has leased for a couple of months and to get bearings. She is going to the lodge in the forest down south in an anonymous profound south state to think of her subsequent book. En route to the lodge, she gets lost and maneuvers into a service station where she experiences a gathering of oil heads. She inadvertently spills some liquid on the top of the gathering, Johnny, and raises a ruckus around town button on her vehicle, terrifying him. Different folks ridicule him for getting terrified. Jennifer crashes off into the rock street to the lodge. A couple of days pass and nothing peculiar occurs. One evening, she starts to hear commotions now and again that make her uncomfortable. Her most memorable guest is Matthew, a nearby bonehead jack of all trades, who is shipped off the lodge to fix the wrecked latrine. His prize is a kiss from Jennifer, and the modest Matthew runs out of the lodge. He later gets together with the gathering, and the folks start to discuss Jennifer. They have a thing against extravagant city young ladies who are excessively great for them. Sunset comes and Jennifer starts to hear commotions around the house. She checks and tracks down nothing. Yet, the following day, Jennifer's feelings of trepidation are acknowledged when the group from the service station shows up at the lodge to get Matthew laid. After they meddle with her, causing her to perform fellatio on bottles and a firearm, she can get away from the lodge and runs off into the forest. She chances upon the sheriff and Duke, the elderly person she leased the lodge from. The sheriff advises Lord to wait while he takes Jennifer back to the lodge, behaving like he will help her. He tracks down wine and a joint and starts to grill her. After an ill-advised search, the young men get through the entryway and she understands that they are thick as thieves. They hold her down, so Matthew can assault her. After he is finished, she simply gets up and leaves the lodge and into the forest. She is stood up to by the posse once more, this time they each have a turn assaulting her. The sheriff Annalie assaults her, she gets up once more and leaves the forest and onto an extension. At the point when the sheriff will shoot her, Jennifer bounces into the stream. The group looks for her body yet have no karma tracking down her and start to dispose of any proof abandoned. A month passes before Jennifer returns. She has made do in the forest for a month eating, as she makes sense of later, bugs and different things and has been remaining in a summery lodge in the forest. She begins messing around with the gathering who all think Matthew has lost it when they begin to find indications of Jennifer around that seam, by all accounts, to be left as an indication of the wrongdoing. Jennifer's most memorable casualty is Matthew, the slowest of the pack who has a keen interest in her and is the one in particular that feels regret for his activities. At the point when she at long last uncovers herself to him in a lodge and welcomes him to sit on a sofa close to her, he wails and says he's sorry over and over as he grips to her midsection and lies close to her. She tunes in for a period, then pulls a noose tight around his neck. As he battles for air and again says he's grieved, her face folds and she says that is not adequate, then hauls him outside by the rope. Her second and third casualties are the gathering's two attendants. Stanley, the fat one, steps in a bear trap, and Andy, who gets taken out with a slugging stick. Jennifer utilizes fish snares to keep Stanley's eyes open while she takes out a fish and guts it, and spreads the guts all around his face. This is all being recorded on his camera, a similar camera he used to film her being assaulted. The fish guts draws in crows, who start to peck all over and in the long run his eyeballs. Andy is tied up lying on a couple of sheets over a bath being loaded up with water. Jennifer tosses in a few lie and eliminates one of the sheets, constraining him to utilize his solidarity to avoid the base. In the end his face raises a ruckus around town-filled bath. Each time he pulls himself up we see his base-consumed face, with his tongue disintegrated. The following day, Jennifer goes to the nearby service station where she assaults and takes out Johnny and takes him back to her lodge. There, she strings Johnny up by his wrists to the roof of the lodge, peels all the garments off him and starts to take out his teeth individually with pincers. Then she takes out the trimmers and removes his penis and sticks it in his mouth, passing on him to drain to death. After Jennifer is finished with Johnny, she goes to visit the sheriff's loved ones. Claiming to be his girl's teacher, she converses with him on the telephone. The sheriff races home to find Jennifer is no longer there. He figures out she has taken his little girl to the jungle gym. The sheriff races there to see as nobody, with the exception of Jennifer in the secondary lounge of his cop vehicle. After the sheriff awakens from the blow from the tire iron, Jennifer discusses how pleasant his little girl appears and disregards for some time his supplications not to hurt her, pushing a rifle barrel inside him as she advises him to envision somebody harming his little girl the manner in which they generally hurt her. At the point when he at last says, "She's a guiltless young lady," she bows close to him and says, "So was I." She then, at that point, uncovers she joined a string to the trigger and the opposite end has been tied around the unconscious Matthew's wrist. She leaves the lodge with the sheriff yelling for help and reviling her out simultaneously. Then Matthew awakens and in spite of a bombed endeavor by the sheriff to quiet Matthew down, Matthew moves, shooting the shotgun, killing both the sheriff and Matthew. In the last shot, the quiet yet Jennifer is then seen sitting on a tree trunk outside the lodge, gradually grinning when she hears the shot and acknowledges they're undeniably wrapped up.